More common now are the EEPROMs, and we'll see in a moment where we get into an EEPROM. EEPROM stands for Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. Now, especially if you have older machines, you may notice that older machines will have an EEPROM chip loaded on the motherboard. That's where your BIOS, your basic input-output system, is going to be burned in. These types of chips are available to be upgraded. What you can do is, if you'll notice, most of these EEPROM chips have a label or a sticker on the top. Now, the sticker normally has some sort of identification markings, version numbers, manufacturer codes. But the real purpose for that label on the top is to cover up a little tiny UV window. The window is typically a circle of clear plastic or glass that's embedded in the top of the chip so that light can reach the physical chip down in the package. And again, we're in the same situation as I mentioned with the CPU. The chip itself is tiny. The package, with all the pins coming out of it, is just the container for the actual chip. So you have a tiny little window, and you can take this chip and put it in a special device that sends or emits a very high intensity ultraviolet light. When you shine this ultraviolet light through the window, it will erase any memory or any programs that are stored on the chip. Then you can start over and you can program it over and over again. The next type, though, now it's normally a hassle to pull the chips out and get your chip into a reader that has an ultraviolet emitter. So designers came up with a different idea, where you can have a chip that can be erasable through electrical means, and that is what EEPROM is, Electrically Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. All right, so let's take a look at that piece by piece. It's read-only memory, which means you can only read from it, you cannot routinely write to it. It's programmable, which means that you can actually change what's in the memory, you can put new instructions in it. It's erasable by some means, and the means by which we erase it is by sending specific electrical charges. Now, these make it very convenient because we can write programs to let the CPU itself send the appropriate electrical charges through a bus to erase the memory and then reprogram it. Very common mechanism, compact flash card is a great example. That's an EEPROM device. It's a card that you can pull out, pop in a machine. We can use them for digital cameras. We can use it for memory storage for many different types of small devices.